So welcome once again in the class of energy and environmental engineering. In today's lecture, we are going to see the noise pollution. I am Mr. S. Sogule, Assistant Professor, Civil Engineering Department. So what is noise? The sound which is unwanted and disturb one's quality of life is known as the noise. The normal sound becomes undesirable when it disturbs our normal activities such as working, sleeping, during conversation. The WHO stated the noise must be recognized as major threat to the human well-being. So what are the types of noises? One is external noise and another is internal noise. In external noise, it is atmospheric noise, then extraterrestrial noise, and industrial noise, man-made noise. And in internal noise, thermal noise is there, transit time noise is there, miscellaneous noises, and short noises. So what is noise pollution? Sound that is unwanted or disturbs the activity or balance of human or animal life is called as a noise. When there is a lot of noise in the environmental, then it is termed as a noise pollution. So what are the sources of noise pollution? These are the main sources of noise pollution, that is household sources, social events, commercial and industrial activities, and transportation. So before moving further, we'll see what are the noises and their levels. So basically, here you can see before this decibels, that is the unit of measuring of the sound. So before this also I will tell. So the 10 is the sound of rustling leaves. Then here you can see, then the soft music or the whisper, that is in between 20 to 30. Then 40, that is average home noise is there. Then this 60, that is normal conversation and background music. Then 70, that is office noise or inside the car at 60 miles per hour. This 75 is the vacuum cleaner or the average radio. This 85 to 89, that is heavy traffic, window air conditioner, noisy restaurant, power lawn mower, etc. So basically this is the limit where the sound, above which the sound can be harmful, that is 80 to 85. Rather, here 85 has been written, but 80 to 85 is the level. Then 90 to 95, that is subway, shouted conversation, etc. 96 to 100, that is boombox, ATV motorcycles are there. Then 101 to 105, that is school dance. Then 106 to 115, that is chainsaw, leaf blower, snowmobiles, etc. Then 120 to 129, that is sports crowd, rock concert, loud symphony is there. 130 is the stock car races, and 140 is the gunshot siren, gunshot and siren at 100 feet. So this is the kind of the volume levels. Those are for particular type of the voices or the sounds that we know. So this is same kind of diagram again. So here again, the same 10 to 160 that is there, and you'll find some different examples, but with this decibel scale. So here floor fan is there, conversation is there, city traffic is there, tractor and hand drill is there, rock concerts, hammer drills are there, pneumatic riveter is there, jet takeoff is there. So these are the known sound to us, and with reference to which this the scale has been shown over here, that which sound produce what kind of decibel. So moving back, when there is a lot of noise in the environmental, in the environment, then it is termed as a noise pollution. So what are the sources of noise pollution? As I told you earlier, the household sources, social events, commercial and industrial activities, and the transportation. Now the household sources. The gadget or the appliances like food mixer, grinder, vacuum cleaner, washing machine and dryer, cooler, air conditioner can be very noisy and injurious to health. Other include the loudspeaker of sound system, then TVs, iPods and earphones, etc. Another example, actually they have mentioned the iPods and earphones over here, because If you heard the constantly with the earphones, you can cause the deafness or the mental headache, etc., or the mental illness. All these things can be happen with the excessive use of earphones. So another example, maybe neighbors are barking all night every day, and every shadow it see disturbing everyone else in the apartment. So that can be an example of the household sources of the noises. So here you can see these are the examples, these are the appliances, then a kind of headphone or the speakers, these the instruments are there, and this is the dog barking. Now the social events, the places of worships, discos and gigs, parties and other social events also create a lot of noise for the people living in that area. So many market areas, people sell with the loudspeakers, that is in markets. Then so others shout out offers and try to get the customers to buy their goods. Then it is important to note that where these events are not often, they can be called as nuisance rather than the noise pollutions. Actually, this worship and discos and all these things are not frequent or regular activities. They are quite periodically activities, so they call nuisance rather than the noise pollution, but they are part of this noise pollution. So here you can see the example, that a disco, then this people gathering at the one place, then this is the worship event or the Mironok rather we call it. This is also one of the social event or the speech for the elections, etc. Now the commercial industry and activities. So printing presses, manufacturing industries, construction site contribute the noise pollution in large cities. In many industries, it is a requirement that people always wear earplug to minimize their exposure to the heavy noise. So this is the requirement in many kind of industries. So people who work with noisy equipment are required to wear the noise proof gadgets. Here you can see these are the industries, and these are the cutting machines, etc. Those are creating the noise. Then the transportation. So airplanes flying over the houses close to the busy airports, that creates the noise or disturbing to the occupant, those are living into those houses. The overground and underground trains, vehicle on roads, those are constantly making a lot of noises. So what are the noises? Noise level. So you can see luxury level bus will make a noise of 77 decibels, small passenger car 79 decibels, miniature passenger car 84 decibels, sports car 91 decibels, motorcycle 4 stroke 94, and motorcycle 2 stroke that is 80 decibels. So these are the tentative quantities that those are producing the noises in particular decibel level. What are the effect of the noise pollution? So those are divided into three categories, that is on human, on environment and on animals. So on humans, noise pollution is a reason of cause of nervous disorder, headache, high blood pressure and short memory, depression and fatigue, which considerably reduce the efficiency of the person. Because of noise pollution, we must get a depression or the fatigue, which will reduce our efficiency. In frustration and difficulty in concentration, disturbance of the rest, physical and mental fatigue. So these are the some effects of the noise pollution. Then chronic exposure to noise may cause the noise induced hearing loss. So this is the main thing that I have told earlier. Constantly near the noise can cause us the hearing loss. Here you can see we might got the deafness. Then the stress has been there, that is annoyance and the stress. So these are the things that we can cause with the help of this, with the help means because of this noise pollution, heart attack and high BP, etc. What is the effect on the environment? So noise has a detrimental effect on the growth of some plants. Bird as well rely on the hearing to help them find their to prey, and hence they are seriously disadvantaged by noise. So because of the noise, is breaking the earth's barrier and could lead to destruction of the world in about 2-3 years. The noise pollution causes the poor quality of crops in pleasant atmosphere. And now the animal. The noise pollution damages the nervous system of the animals. Increase of death by altering the prey or predator detection and avoidance. Then animal loses the control of its mind. Create the problem in their use of sound in reproduction and navigation. They becomes dangerous and attacking because of this noise pollution. Noise pollution from ship engines and sonar systems make it difficult for the marine mammals like whales, dolphins, and prevents it from communicating and finding food and avoiding hazards. So this is because of the noise from the ship engines and sonar system. The excessive noise has the ability to raise the animal's heartbeat speed and even harms the animal's metabolism. So these are the some things or effects of noise pollution on the animal. So here you can see these are the effects. This is sonar and all those things. Now, how to prevent this noise pollution? First thing, do not use car horns unnecessarily. Areas like hospital and campus are silent zones and horning is prohibited there because already the patients are there, and to make their condition more worse, this noise pollution will help. So to reduce that, the horning in that particular area can be avoided or the prohibited. Then motors, machines, vehicles also produce loud noises when not maintained properly. Proper maintenance should be carried out for better performance. Then we can turn off the engine and motor by of car and motorbike when we are not using it. It stops the annoying hum and reduces the air pollution also. Then if you are working in an area where there is a lot of noises, we must wear the earplugs to prevent the loss of hearing. Then rake leaves by hand, don't use the noisy leaf blower. Then trim bushes and shrubs by hand, don't use the noisy brush trimmer. So these are the simple things that we can do. Don't use the blast music on the radio or the computer or speaker. Be considerate of your own ears and those are around you. Train your dog not to bark so much. Do noisy thing, that is dishes, hammerings, etc. over on a rubber mat to reduce the noise. So these are all the things by which we can reduce the noise pollution. Also same thing are there that we can educate the people. We can provide the no horn zones, etc. on the particular places. Then by way we can make the act for the noises. Even in case of our festivals like Ganapati, Diwali or Eid, etc. We can restrict the people with the noise level. And currently government is doing so these things. This ban on Dolby systems, etc. So all these things are there. By using which we can reduce the noise pollution. So reference for this is slideshare.net. So thank you for today's lecture.